Whenever we need to make a decision, we first identify all the choices, analyze the gains and the losses for each of those choices. Whichever gives us the maximum gains or the lowest loss, we pick that option. But a lot of times, the maximum gain or the minimum loss option is not very evident, or the gap between two choices is not very clear. What do we do in those cases? If possible, we pick multiple options and maximize the cumulative gain. For example, when we are buying breakfast cereals, if you're not clear on which one we actually like most, we probably buy two or three and experiment on them. Similar is the case where we are buying gifts, where we are not able to choose between the options provided by, say, the online vendor, between the combinations of the cakes, of the gifts, flowers and chocolates. We probably pick multiple options, or we pick one option and add a top up. So what we're trying to do is club different options and maximize the gain. Same is the case for making a choice of cable TV plans, where if none of the plans the vendor is providing has your favorite channels, you probably pick multiple plans, or you pick one plan and add top-ups. Same is the situation where if you're buying a pack of socks, and if we like two colors in one pack and three colors in another pack, either we buy both, or we think that someday this guy is going to make another combination with my favorite colors, so let me not buy this pack of socks right now. Let me wait for this guy to come up with a newer option. So what that makes us do is, initially, when we started out making decisions, if we had one or two choices, it becomes very easy for us to make a decision. And when we get more choices, we become more happy because we now have more options to choose from. But if you look at this interesting graph that I found online, there is only a point till where having a lot of options actually makes us happy, because after a point in time, too many options is not good for us, because that ends up like the sock situation, making no decision at all. Now consider the situation of shopping for electronics. There are so many options that a lot of us actually get confused and think that let me wait for a few more years and see if the company comes with an even better option, even faster processor, right? Same is the case with social media apps, where maintaining a profile in one particular social media app is not going to help us, because different apps have different benefits, and so we want to wait for that one app that is going to rule the market, and then we want to... what we're trying to do here is, of all the options that have been provided to us, we are trying to find the best option of the best of the good options we have. We are not choosing between good and bad. We are choosing the best from all the good options we have. I've seen a lot of people maintain multiple credit cards just because they are not able to choose that one credit card that they think will be beneficial for them. Same is the case with life partner, where people end up not getting married or not choosing a life partner because they are overwhelmed with the choices that they have, and so they are not able to find that one person who has the combination of all the attributes that they've seen in different people. Now, what I want to try and say here is that when we're taking a decision, we probably always think that we are taking a linear decision. This is me in isolation. I have these four options, and depending on my choice, the output is going to be different. That is true. Our choices determine who we are. Making smart choices gives us a better life. Making dumb choices may not give us a good life. But when we make choices, we also need to consider that the outcome is not really in our hands completely. Because although we are making a choice, other people are also making their choices. And then there are other factors that are not even in hands of people. For example, the current pandemic situation that completely impact the final output. And so while we think that our decision is going to be the ultimate thing that will decide our life, there are other factors that are beyond our control, other people beyond our control who are also taking decisions who will end up impacting the final output. And so what I'm trying to say is that when we are faced with the situation of not being able to choose anything because we have a lot of choices, making no decision is also a decision, because status quo is also a state of mind. And so if you want to buy a TV, and as of today you do not have a TV, by waiting for two more years, you have made the decision to not buy a TV today. So that is also a decision. So sitting in one place and analyzing your options, it also means that you've already decided that none of those options are good enough. And so when you start thinking in that direction, maybe you will start feeling that if no decision is also a decision, let me pick a decision that is better than making a no decision, or that is better than the status quo. And when we we take that decision, we should own the consequence. We should not take a decision just for the sake of it because someone pressurized us, or we think that the deal will be over or the discount is going to get off. We should own the consequence of whatever decision we make. And we do make bad choices. And although we own the consequence, if it was a bad choice, let us analyze the options we had. Let us see which one is the best one. If it went bad, okay, fine. Gain from it, and from next time onwards, add it into your stack of tools for analyzing in future. But although you've made a bad choice, don't brood over it, don't sit over it for years together and regret the fact that you made that one choice. Because a lot of times we are all wiser, smarter in hindsight. A lot of decisions are very obvious in hindsight. If you sit today and think about the decisions you made 2 years back, a lot of things will look obvious today because this is the benefit of hindsight. However, you will only know that at that point in time where the decision had to be made, it was not at all obvious, right? Because in hindsight, you have the benefit of seeing what other people did or how other factors impacted the output of the decision. In this point in time, you do not have that benefit. And so even if you make a bad choice, think about it, learn from it, but forgive yourself for making a bad choice. Move on, and the next time try and make a better decision. But just think that you not making a decision is also a decision. And in the end, I wanted to say that the best way to make a decision in case of the situation where you feel that your decision making has been paralyzed because of over analyzing, think of a principle based decision making process. Principles could be general life principles that you swear by. These could be things like, I will take that decision that will make me rich, that is, that will multiply my money. Or I will take that decision in which I will have complete autonomy of the situation. Or I will take a decision in which I will not be powerless. I will take a decision that will be low risk for me, lowest risk in terms of safety, security, could be finance, could be anything. Or I will take a decision that will have the lowest impact on my near and dear ones. So once you have that principle of your life clearly outlined, it will become very easy for us to break the paralysis that we have gone into because of doing over analysis. Just think about how you would break analysis paralysis and share your thoughts with me in the comment section.